YouTube, what is going on? Heir of Carthage here, back on Total War Rome 2, and I've got some replays for you. And over the next couple of replays, so it'll be a couple episodes that you should see in the same day here, I'm just going to talk a little bit about how to improve your game, because I've honestly been thinking about it, and I don't try real hard to improve my game, to be honest, and I probably should. Well, I say I should, it's not like someone requires me to, or I'm like breaking some laws of Total War, but I want to talk about that. So, I wanted to play as Carthage for a little bit, because this game's going to be gone soon enough with the release of Attila. Not gone for good, per se, but, you know, obviously it'll change focus, probably. Unless people just really like Rome 2 better than Attila, we'll see. So I wanted to play with Carthage, because I'm not going to get the chance to use them in Attila. And, just decided to kind of just bring kind of a random Carthage army. Not something I think is a great build. Because, to be honest, I want to be good at the game. I just don't want to repeat the same thing all the time, and there's ways to combine the two of those. I think if you're going to get really serious and get in tournament play, you probably do have to use the most sound, time-tested strategies, but you'll also notice that a lot of the tournament players who do well, I think that I know of a couple of good examples. I know Duck and Panda Warrior and Armenian King and some of the others that I've seen do really well in the tournaments, they always have like a little bit of... They like to spice things up a little bit. There's always like that trick up their sleeve, that let's have some fun kind of thing. And I like that. That to me is entertaining. Because otherwise, for me, it just gets boring when it comes to like, excuse me, pick, counter pick, counter unit pick, all that kind of stuff. Now, don't get me wrong. That's smart if you're playing to win. It just gets kind of old. And so it's kind of fun to try something different. And that's what I did here, so I was going to bring a Carthaginian Sacred Band, just because they don't get used a whole lot. It's a fairly strong unit. Against a faction like Colchis, like I'm facing, I'm not too worried about bringing it. I've got a couple of Libyan infantry and then some Carthaginian Hoplites. Now, my idea with this army is that I don't mind... So I know that Colchis can only field nobles, and I'm not real familiar with how strong they are, because I honestly can't say that I've faced Colchian nobles before, and there are some on the field. Looks like they're mainly just tanky with armor and morale and stuff. They have expert charge defense, too. It was just something that I was like, you know what, I don't feel like Colchis has any infantry that's just going to whack right through mine in a minute. So I wanted to bring an army and just try something different. I see him screening with his hillmen, so I'm going to charge them, because I know that his Colchian nobles don't have javelins. Colchian nobles, whatever they're called. I did the same thing over here. And I'm going to quickly pull both my cavalry units out, decimating that hillman unit. And my guys don't get a charge here for the most part, which is a mistake. Now, for my hoplites, it's not the biggest thing in the world, because they can brace for a charge. And I have expert charge defense in the Sacred Band, so again, that should be fine. So my sword unit over here, I don't believe got a charge. They got charged by the Colchian nobles. And they're doing very well so far. And they're going to go into Hoplite Phalanx, which is going to make that tough to break them. Then over here, my Carthaginian Hoplite's going to get charged by Axemen. So Axemen, I kind of expect that they would probably grind out a fight pretty well versus Hoplites, since Hoplites are high armor, low attack. But again, I didn't figure that they would do so quickly. And so what I wanted to do was gain an advantage with my Balearic Slingers. So I'm quickly mopping up his Eastern Slingers. And I'm going to start putting some pressure on his flanks. Now, you're going to notice lots of times here that my micro is slow. And that's something that you can do to improve your game. And I normally play my games like this, where I'm watching my army from behind, because it just kind of seems intuitive. But I'm actually going to start experimenting and try playing the game like this, because notice how I can see behind myself here. And during the battle, I figured my opponent had something hidden, because he started down here by the woods, but I forgot to keep looking. Now, fortunately, I just happened to have these Hoplites out here who are in a decent position to ward this off, but I go around the flank, taking all my units, and then don't realize that I just leave my opponent wide open in my backfield here with horse archers and a very dangerous unit of Hippias Lancers. So his Colchian nobles knock out my Libyan infantry here very handily, actually. My guys don't fight all that well there, but I'm going to try and get some rear charges. My opponent's going to try and pin me in with Eastern Spearmen. I should have just turned around, so again, something you can do to make your game better. Eastern Spearmen on the move are worthless against cavalry. I should have turned around and charged them and then charged on through. Otherwise, now I let my guys get pinned. So I'm going to talk about things here that I do wrong, that my opponent does wrong, because I really want to start, you know, just for fun, trying to focus and see if I can get better at multiplayer. Does it mean I want to win tournaments or this? No, I just want to try and improve my game, just for the fun of it. I decided I'm going to try and do the same thing in Halo, which is going to be harder because I understand Halo a lot less than I do Total War. And understanding a game and being good at it are actually two different things. You need to understand a game to be good at it, but you can understand a game and still not be good at it, in my opinion. So I get a clean charge into these Hippias Lancers, but my opponent, rather than stick around and fight my Noble Cav, he just keeps running into the back of my men, trying to get these rear charge penalties, and that's not a bad plan. His Hippias Lancers are going to die one way or the other. They got a lot of Slinger kills, that's where most of their kills came from, but just see how it broke these late Libyan Hoplites that were helping to plug the gap, and that's pretty bad for me. My Slingers, though, can make short work of his Horse Archers. They're way too close here, and they probably should be trying to get into my Slingers, but they can't because there's this Scutari Cav around, and it's going to help mop up the Hippias. But you can see the Hippias continues to just ignore my Cav attacks, and my opponent's going to repeatedly keep pulling back into my my lines. Now, I'm pulling rear charges as well, and it's going to hurt these Axemen pretty bad getting rear charged by Scutari Cav. Eastern Spearmen dying to my late Libyans, and then I'm losing some Cav back here to a combination of Citizen Cav and Hoplites. So, and my opponent's army, we'll get to see it at the end. But yeah, see how his Hippias Lancer is still alive, still doing rear charges, and that rear charge penalty hurts. My Hoplites are starting to give way. And then my men come up here and get caught up in this fight against his Colchian Nobles, and they also get rear charged by Citizen Cav here, which is bad. So, you know, there's a lot of things that I'm doing wrong here. Number one, I'm letting my Cav get bogged down in these fights. You shouldn't do that, especially melee Cav. It needs to stay nimble. It's going to take lots of cycle charges to knock out enemy units, so keep your Cav nimble, and watch out for getting it into positions where it'll get caught, like I did here. Now again, the battle's not over. I've got a lot of fight left in me. I've got Valeric Slingers back here that my opponent has no answer to right now, and I'm going to use them. And so, out of all the mistakes I made, one good thing I did was I kept two units of my Slingers alive, and I kept my general alive here too. Barely. But I'm going to pull my general out of this fight. He got quite a few kills, a lot of Hippias Lancer kills, and, well, actually most of his kills were probably that Hillman unit initially. So Carthaginian Noble Cav is really bad. I, again, just brought it because I rarely do and figured it would be fun to, you know, have hope that maybe they don't suck, but they do. Nothing's changed. So yeah, I'm just going to keep plugging the gap with late Libyan Hoplites. These guys are so worth their money. They've got great armor and pretty good melee defense. Actually, never mind. They have terrible melee defense. But whatever. They have good armor, and they can hold in a fight for just a little bit. And it's not real economic for my opponent to have to fight his way through these guys while getting rear-charged. So, like these Colchian Nobles, for instance, doing very well. I say that. They're getting handily destroyed by the Sacred Band. Sacred Band is definitely a tougher unit. It's got far higher attack, although a little less weapon damage, it looks like. Yeah, that Sacred Band is more than enough match for the Colchian Nobles. Anyway, the rear charges are going to continue. Just looking to get the penalties. The enemy general is going to die soon, and I am hoping that that helps break up the enemy army. My opponent's Axemen, some of them are doing very well. And again, like I said, Axemen tend to do well against units in prolonged combat that have high armor. Anyway, my Slingers here are actually firing into the back of these Colchian Nobles. So they do have a lot of armor. Slingers actually have pretty good AP damage. So firing into the back of his men here is going to be good in a couple of ways. It's doing AP damage, and it's bypassing his shield. And otherwise, it would be pretty hard to kill Colchian Nobles from the front. These guys are getting hammered pretty bad. And again, they're over here having to deal with late Libyan Hoplites while this expensive Hoplite unit is getting hammered in the back by Slingers. Slingers are quite good at this if you can keep them to the late game. They're a very dangerous unit, especially Valeric Slingers. I did use rapid reloads, so my men are a little tired. That's always a risk you take, which can make it bad for kiting. And my enemy's peltist here. My guys get caught up on them for a moment. Anyway, the enemy general's dead at this point. Again, I'm keeping my general at a safe distance because I nearly got him killed, and I'm also keeping the Scutari Cav. And the reason being is if I have to get to late game and start kiting, I kept these two Cav units in reserve so that I could buy time for my Slingers to keep firing, basically, if I was about to get in a bad situation. But my infantry over here on this flank did very well, and I was able to support them with enough rear charges and infantry support. I initially had a lot of infantry support over here and rear charges, so I bested the enemy over here. These Colchian Nobles did really bad. And some of his Colchian Nobles, though, did admirably. These Hoplites are getting shot in the non-shielded flank by Valeric Slingers. That's definitely a goodbye, goodnight kind of scenario. And then I bring in my Scutari at the last minute to try and deliver some rear charge penalties. But the battle was over. So what did I do right and what did I do wrong here? Number one, I don't really think I brought the best army for countering Colchis. I didn't pay enough attention to my back line. I let my opponent get his Hippeus Lancers behind me when I could have easily distracted them with a unit of late Libyan hoplites. I had plenty of them. The Sacred Band unit, actually, I don't think was a bad pick versus Colchis, because these guys don't have a very good answer to Sacred Band. Normally, high-powered sword units will just eat these guys for lunch, but Colchis doesn't have high-powered sword units, and so it actually makes these guys a pretty tough nut to crack. And Eastern Slingers are great, and I think that it's a good choice for people who have access to them to bring them, but they're going to die bad to Balearic Slingers, and in this case they did. Axemen, again, potentially useful. You can see a couple of his units doing very well, a couple of them not so well. Kind of just depends on how they get used and how you use them. His general went up against my Sacred Band and was soundly defeated. I think he went against the Sacred Band fight, and yeah, he got defeated bad. Other Colchian nobles, though, that's a respectable amount of kills for a spear unit there. Now, it could have been against late Libyans, I don't know, but still, that's a lot of kills for a spear unit to rack up during the course of a battle. And to be honest, if you look at these hillmen, these guys got a lot more kills than I think they probably could have, considering I blasted them with cavalry right at the beginning of the battle, which is the main reason why my noble cavalry has any kills. And to be honest, the fact that the noble cav couldn't rout the hillman on an unbraced charge is pretty pathetic. Skitarii cav, this one doing pretty well. This one probably not as much. And I got some nice kills on this Carthaginian cav here as well. And the slingers, of course, really play in the game. But if you look, 135 kills on late Libyan hoplites is fantastic. 88 kills. Any kills on these guys are really good because they're cheap units. A couple of my hoplites did a great job holding. Sacred Band, these hoplites, okay-ish there. 72, okay-ish. And again, one of my Libyan infantry beasted, and the other one got tanked. And I don't know why. I'd have to go back and look at it closer. But again, I'll give you a few more hints in the next video about what I was thinking of to try and improve my gameplay, and we'll see how I do. And I'll just keep kind of holding myself to it each video, and we'll have some fun with it, see if I can boost my game. Anyway, hope you all enjoyed it. HeirofCarthage, signing off for now.